Here we are on the fly, on the set, Eli Field more like. It's a balmy 90 degrees, sunny Monday afternoon. Pete and I are out here filming the latest Hangar 9 release video. This is the KI-43 Oscar, which hopefully by the time you see this video, the plane will be released and we'll be selling like gangbusters. But yeah, this gives you an insight of what we do for a video production. Generally a two-man crew, myself and Pete on this one. We have another videographer, Alan. We have a photographer, Rory, who works on Hangar 9, and another photographer, Ben, who does e-flight. But yeah, generally a two-man crew will come out here for the day, weather depending, and do what needs to be done. It's a lot more than people think. I was surprised when I joined the company as Hangar 9 developer. I thought the videos would be like, ah, yeah, go out in the morning and get it all done. But there's a bunch of stuff to do. It's setting up the shots, as you can see Pete's doing. He's doing what we call glamour at the moment, which is basically the close-up, the stills and the videos. So he'll be doing those little B-rolls that you'll see spliced into the video where it pans around the plane and makes it look beautiful. He's also doing the glamour stills, which we use for our web production stuff. So you'll see on the website, lots of still images. They'll be done some in the studio, some out here. And then my job is to stand here and look ugly until need be, and then I start doing the flying bit, which is a whole new set of fun and games. Basically we'll fly and fly and fly. All three of these airplanes will be flown multiple times. To get something like a 3 minute, 4 minute video, we generally tend to take about 4 hours worth of footage, or out here for 4 hours filming flying footage. So yeah, really a lot that goes into it. And this is just the easy bit. This is the flying field stuff. Pete then has to take all of the content, put it into time code, which is basically a video with a timer running next to it, so I can look at it, approve and go, okay, this snippet is good, that section isn't good, and draw from these sections to take down 4 hours worth of footage and whittle it down to around about 10 minutes normally. And then Pete will work with that 10 minutes and edit it down and try and make it look beautiful. So yeah, just a quick overview. Hopefully the next time you see, or the first time you see this, and the next time I see it as a dump production, will be when the Oscar's in production and yeah, the video's all done.
So what I'm doing actually, so we can document this properly, is I'm just recording the entire time.
Sure, no problem.
Sounds good.
The things we won't be showing you on the product video.
So what I reckon we should do this time is just do a scale flying video. Just based on feedback.
Yeah.
I've very rarely heard people go, oh, it looks really cool that it will do all the crazy stuff. But I hear a lot of, oh man, why don't you get somebody who can fly and fly like a scale plane? So,
which you can.
I don't know, still learning. But yeah, I think with this one, with that in mind, just gonna go with scale stuff. And then I'll probably do some organic, my own personal videos, because this thing does some mental tumbles, like inside Longevac sort of things, yeah, that generate into some crazy flat spins. I'd like to show that, but not in this product video.
Sure. A little quick modifications there.
Yeah. Lightning.
Oh yeah, yeah, nice.
Cross brakes. I hope it is on a structural. I didn't design it to be structural. Keeps the top, but the top's still pretty rigid. It was impeding my sliding in the batteries in and out. So that's the technical, diplomatic way around it. The truthful way is I kept smashing it every time I slid the batteries in and out. So yeah, a little bit of hacksaw. I do not recommend this at home. Do not modify your Hangar 9 KI-43 Oscar.
This may or may not make it to the final video.
Blooper reel, right?
Yeah.
So I put a time frame into all of this for the on-the-fly video. This aeroplane is prototype number one. This is the very first sample aircraft they sent me based on my drawings or my design. We got this in September of last year. So it's coming up to a year old. It's probably done in the region of 30 or 40 flights. That would be an approximation. It may be a little bit more than that, but yeah, this is the bog stock kit as it came. So this is the one that I based all the snag list on, send it back to the factory and say, look, change this, change that. Then the second one came, which is the Sato one, which I was happy with. And the third one came as a confirmation, production confirmation. I mean, through the camera, you'll probably see no differences at all. But to give you an idea, from this one to that one, there was in the region of 30 to 40 different, I call them squawks or snag lists. So yeah, I sent them 30 to 40 different things that could be changed, I'd like changed, and the factory did that and sent us back an example, and I was happy to be final sample on three with this. So we've done a whole bunch of flying, basically ad-libbing it. What do you want to see next, Pete?
So really it's kind of the low and slow stuff. I really like the where we have the plane in focus and the background, the trees whizzing by it. Gotcha. We can slow that down, do it at like 60 frames. If I can get a couple passes both directions.
Just down there in the tree line.
Exactly.
So air show passes.
Beautiful, yep.
Hope you got that.
I did.
That's what happens when you're so busy getting the shot, you forget there's bushes. Well, I want to see that, it'll look cool. Right, yeah. Anyway, back to work.
Oh, all right, we'll take a break for a quick second.
Okay, I think I've lost the flap anyway.
Okay.
No flap landing on grass. Was going to tip over, this is the one.
Oh, come loose?
I think it's come off the horn.
Ah.
We'll have a look.
For my personal favourite.
Everyone's personal favourite. Yeah. By saying that, I may have ruined it. I've changed the prop. I took a winning formula, it was working perfectly all the way through testing, all the way through the tease videos, and I was like, oh, we're just about to do the product video. You know what I'll do? I'll change something. Yeah.
Well, we'll see, I guess.
I got so carried away starting the engine, I put the air in it. If I remember at this point.
Yeah.
Hey, what did I put air in it? I can't remember. No, I didn't. They all look the same, they're all green and silver. Oh, I love this engine and plane combo.
I'm getting ready here. How's the prop feel?
It's quarter power, I can't tell yet.
Nah.
Definitely slower. Which is good.
Which means more scale, right?
Yeah, I thought it was too fast on the two-bladed prop.
Give me a landing.
I'll be landing. Mandatory to have popcorn.
Well, hey guys, thanks so much for joining us for this episode. Hopefully you liked seeing a little bit more behind the scenes. We want to kind of show you guys what our day-to-day is. Hopefully you enjoyed it.
Eating popcorn. Definitely a behind the scenes on the fly. This is Pete's office. It's rare that I come in here and only come in here armed with popcorn to edit and see what the final cut's going to be like. But hopefully, this is an insight into what goes into us making a video, a day shooting of a Hangar 9 video, the e-flight videos, I'm sure the car videos, the pro boat videos,
are very much the same. Yeah, we hope to do more of these, show you some more of the development, show you more behind the scenes, what we do, who does it. Also, other people at Horizon, there's some really interesting characters doing some cool jobs, so yeah.
Yeah, we shot this because, you know, it seemed like you guys were interested in it. You know, a little bit more of the inside scoop. So let us know what you guys are interested in, what you guys want to see. Be sure and leave a comment. Thanks, guys.
Thumbs up.
All right.
Okay.
Gonna work out any better. It's better to be lucky than good, Pete.